Hello friends, welcome to Share Market Friend again. Today I'm going to talk about one of the circular that is going to get implemented, that is circular of NSE. Okay, so it is circular with reference to SEBI. It is going to get implemented from mostly 21 to 22 of this month. Okay, so it is about basically changes in margin. Those are charged for selling any option of call or put of index or individual stock. Okay, I have made so many videos on various topics. If you like any, you can check it out into my video section on my channel in Share Market Friend. Okay, so come back to this circular. Actually, there is a good explanation given on Zerodha support portal. Zerodha is the biggest brokerage in India. So I'm not making this out of sponsorship, this video, but there is a good explanation I found on their website. So I'm explaining what they have explained in their blog or in their support portal. Okay, so basically, first, before explaining this, I will show you one their FNO margin calculator. Okay, here it is a FNO margin calculator of Zerodha brokerage. Okay, so if you select NFO and option, then Nifty January expiry date, then select call, and then I currently Nifty is running at around 11,000 or 10,000 in between. So I have selected 11,800 strike price and select sell. So you get this two part of premium or total margin required to sell that particular call. So first is span margin and then second is exposure margin. Okay, and this is receivable part of it. So currently due to this changes in margin calculation, this span margin and exposure margin will get affected. As you can see, exposure margin is around 24,000. It may change according to strike and according to volatility, etc. So please consider this as one example. Okay, so this is span margin and that is 43,000, exposure margin 24,000. So come back to this explanation. After this first of all, let's check how span margin is calculated. Okay, basically span margin is calculated by considering one day's movement of Nifty or whatever stock it is. So earlier, to calculate this span margin, NSE or SEBI was considering one day's volatility for calculating that span margin requirement. Now they have revised this to 2 days volatility. Maybe it is due to recent spikes in volatility and the systemic risk that posed to the system if they don't keep margin of 2 days to protect overall system from collapsing in case there is a spurt in volatility suddenly. Okay, so also span margin depends on price, scan, or range. Okay, we won't be going too much into the calculation, but I will overall I will tell you that this price scan margin is calculated in volatility terms, kind of sigma and standard deviation. Okay, that is altogether a big chapter itself. So earlier the PSR of 5%, minimum PSR of 5% were required for index and 7.5% for stock. Now they have mandated that to multiply that requirement by 1.4, that is square root of around 2. Okay, so it will be this span margin will be multiplied by 1.4. That is what I understood by this explanation. I hope I am right. You can correct me, please. Okay, so this is the changes in span margin. Also, the exposure margin was earlier 3% for index and 5% for FNO. Now they have increased it by 1.24%, that is 4.24 for index and 7.07 for individual stock. So span margin will increase by around 1.4 times plus whatever the changes will be, and exposure margin will increase by around 2 to 3% depending on stock and Nifty's volatility. Also, there is third change in premium holding, that is short option minimum margin. It is a margin that is held by exchanges or maintained or required to be maintained by brokerages on hold. That is, It is for out of the money options, means a particular range is defined for Nifty or stock, that is PSR of 7% movement is defined, and beyond those beyond that movement, whatever options comes, they are charged with short option minimum margin apart from volatility. So these changes are only for index and not for stock option. I'm talking about short option minimum only. Okay, so but other changes of span and exposure margin will apply to for stock F&O also. Okay, these are the changes that they have roughly given the calculation of around 10,000 for Nifty, and for Bank Nifty it will be affected by 7,000. So depending on volatility, it can go beyond that also. To explain a rough impact on overall span and margin calculation, they have given one spreadsheet. Actually, this whole credit goes to Zerodha itself. They have explained it very easily and simply. Okay, so this is the script name, and this is underlying, and this is lot size, and this is current span, and this is revised, and this is basically the important thing that is different. So maximum it may change up to 45%, and also there is a various range up to which it can change. I have searched for Nifty, and it shows that it will impact around 12 to 13% in the premium that is required for selling and options. So overall it will impact the sellers basically, and then it will impact the buyers also in the long term. Actually, this move is basically to make the system safer for buyers and sellers, and overall to reduce the systemic risk. That is what I understood by this move. It is a little bit difficult and negative for the sellers because they will need more money to sell a particular option, etc. So if you like this video, please click on the like, and please subscribe my channel. Whoever has subscribed the channel, thank you very much. You can check out my this other videos also. Okay, this video's whole credit goes to Zerodha. Actually, they have explained it very well, and this is a circular from NSE clearing that mandates these changes. Okay, thank you for listening, Share Market Friend.